everyone, welcome back again with us from Group 4. Today, we would like to present our final project presentation for International Strategy and Policy. Today, we would like to talk about Gojek. Before we start our presentation, let me introduce our team member first. Our team consists of Christopher Jordan, Kija Sharon, Michelle Bionsi, Putri Awalia, Putu Gedelila, and the last one is Sing Nying Sue. And then for today's presentation, we will cover several parts from company profile, competitor analysis, competitive advantage, Gojek's problems, AAA framework, location of strategies of tangible and intangible asset, and the last one is executed strategy and how Gojek implement this strategy. So without any further ado, let's jump up to the first part, which company profile. Gojek is a company that creates on-demand smartphone apps for ride-hailing and many other services. The company's apps offer services such as transportation and logistics, food ordering and delivery, digital payment, shopping, shipping, news, and entertainment. The form of Gojek services is application-based, where customer can access all the services provided with only a few taps on their smartphones. The company was founded in 2009 in Jakarta, Indonesia by Kevin Alwi, Nadiem Makarim, and Michael Angelo Moran, with the mission of Gojek is dedicated to creating and scaling up positive socio-economic impact on the ecosystem of users, driver partners, business and micro, small, medium enterprise partners, as well as service providers.
Next is the competitor. The biggest Gojek competitor in Indonesia is Grab, but Gojek still leads the market because Gojek has more features that can be accessed by users through the Gojek application, including Gojek, GoCar, GoMassage, GoClean, GoFood, GoMart, GoPay, GoPlay, GoGame, GoTix, GoSend, and GoGive. Meanwhile, Grab only offers GrabBike, GrabCar, GrabFood, GrabExpress, savings packages, GrabCar rental, Good Doctor, GrabCredit, and hotel bookings. In addition, the choice of payment method, Gojek offers more methods which makes it easier for customers. Grab is downloaded by more users, operates in more countries, and has more drivers than Gojek. Next, we're talking about Gojek's competitive advantage. Competitive advantage refers to factors that allow a company to produce goods or services better or more cheaply than its rivals. Gojek has some competitive advantages to compete with its rivals. The first is product innovation. Gojek offers various products and services that customers can enjoy, such as GoFood, GoSend, GoClean, GoAuto, GoFix, GoShop, GoLaundry, GoGlam, GoTix, and GoMassage. In addition, Gojek always makes innovations for its products. Gojek can offer relatively stable and cheap prices compared to its competitors. Stable prices are one of the things that can attract customers and maintain their loyalty. Second is easy and efficient to use the application. All services and products offered by Gojek can be accessed through one application. In addition, for the payment itself, Gojek also has its own e-wallet, namely GoPay, which is integrated directly with the Gojek account so that it will ease the customers when transacting.
Okay, next is Gojek's problem. Also, Gojek appears to be the market leader in Indonesia. It lags behind its competitors in global business expansion. Among Gojek's many competitors, the main competitor is Grab. Grab is a Southeast Asia technology company headquartered in Singapore. It operates in Southeast Asia countries such as Singapore, Malaysia, Cambodia, Indonesia, Myanmar, Philippines, Thailand, and Vietnam. In Southeast Asia, Grab dominates the ride-hailing industry and has consolidated its position by taking over Uber's regional business. In addition, Gojek's global operation scope is not as good as Grab. Gojek only operates in Indonesia, Singapore, Thailand, Vietnam, and India, where Grab operates in 8 countries or regions in Southeast Asia. Moreover, Gojek's market share in Thailand in 2020 is much smaller than that of Grab. In terms of gross merchandise value, Grab Food accounted for 50% of Thailand's $2.8 billion food delivery market in 2020, while Delivery Hero Group's Foodpanda and the Line's Lineman accounted for 23% and 20% respectively. And Gojek's GoFood only has a 7% market share.
So next, Triple F Framework. Triple F Framework aims to help companies decide the most appropriate overall strategy for creating value through international expansion. It consists of three generic international strategies such as adaptation. The most often employed worldwide strategy is adaptation, which involves adjusting one or more part of the company over to match local requirement or preferences. The reason for this is obvious. Some degree of adaptation is required or unavoidable for practically all items in all parts of the world. For example, Gojek in Vietnam has different color and attribute to Gojek in Indonesia. In Vietnam, the attribute is red with a star attribute taken from the Vietnamese national flag. In addition, in Singapore, there is no go-red because there is a ban on motorbike as a public transportation, only available go-karts and go-karts.
The second A is advantage.
Location strategies of tangible and intangible assets. To support business expansion abroad, it is necessary to locate the business properly. Location strategy describes the process company used to determine where the tangible and intangible assets like office and employee should be located. Company assets are all economic resources, both tangible and intangible, owned by an entity that expects to provide business benefit in the future. Gojek tangible assets are office in Indonesia and branch office in partner countries like Malaysia, Singapore, Thailand, Vietnam, and India. The selection of this country was not chosen randomly, but based on data and analysis that the country is profitable if Gojek enters there. The intangible assets owned by Gojek are employees who are respected in their work. Gojek valuation reached $10 billion. Besides that, there is a system that Gojek used in this application to support business operation. And there are also logos, trademark, consumer data, and brand images.
Next is how Gojek implement their strategy execution or which strategy that has been executed by Gojek. First is maintaining and improving service quality for customers. Gojek is a pioneer in online motorcycle and taxi services that is known for its strong brand image, good quality, and customer satisfaction. Therefore, by maintaining and improving the quality of service, consumers will not hesitate to use the service of Gojek and can maintain their loyalty. This can be done by offering punctuality, safety, convenience, and friendly prices for the customers. The second is to create the impression as the best service provider by offering more varied products or services that follow market needs. With the slogan "An Ojek for Every Need," PT Gojek Indonesia not only provides passenger transportation services, but also provides
courier services, shopping services, and food delivery. PT Gojek Indonesia launched the Go World service, which offered three new services, namely cleaning services for cleaning the house or office, massage services for on-call massages, and beauty services like a mobile salon. All types of services can be ordered by customers via the application. PT Gojek Indonesia hopes that the launch of the service can eliminate unemployed people who have expertise but find it difficult to find work, make it easier for customers who are left behind by their assistant, and make it easier for everyone to have relaxation and beauty services without having to go to a spa or salon.
Third point, setting a fairly cheap rate for its service users. Pricing activities play an important role in the marketing mix process. Pricing also gives a certain perception in terms of quality. In this case, PT Gojek Indonesia set a fairly cheap rate for the service user, so the consumer who professionally use regular motorcycle taxis switch to Gojek. So the conclusion, Gojek implements a strategy that focuses on customer satisfaction, like do quality control, do innovation to their services or product, maintaining the performance, and give offering for customer loyalty. Gojek always finds way to differentiate itself from competitors, so they can lead the market. So that's all from our presentation. Thank you for your attention.